टू दिस चैनल गेन जावा नॉलेज एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी हाउ टू पब्लिश ए मैसेज टू काफ्का टॉपिक विद स्प्रिंग बूट एप्लीकेशन. सो के लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड. सो फर्स्ट व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल क्रिएट वन स्प्रिंग बूट प्रोजेक्ट. सो हेयर आई विल टाइप स्टार्ट डॉट स्प्रिंग डॉट आईओ एंड हेयर वी नीड टू चूज प्रोजेक्ट टाइप इज मेमन प्रोजेक्ट एंड लैंग्वेज जावा एंड स्प्रिंग बूट वर्जन. हेयर आई हैव सिलेक्टेड 2.3.4 एंड हेयर वी नीड टू डिफाइन आर्टिफैक्ट आईडी. सो हेयर आई विल टाइप काफ्का प्रोड्यूसर एंड द नेक्स्ट थिंग वी नीड टू एड द डिपेंडेंसीज. So here I have selected Java 8 and click on add and just type web. Then we need to select Spring Web and the next dependency that we need to add is Apache Kafka, that is Spring for Apache Kafka, and next that is Lombok. So no need to write any setter getter method for our model classes and click on generate. Now go to show in folder and extract this file here and open this folder, copy the path, go to Eclipse and click on file, import existing Maven project and browse, then finish. Now we can see here our project is imported successfully. Now what we will do in this video, we will just create a Kafka producer and this producer will send model object. Like we will create one user model and this model will be goes to our Kafka topic and data will be write into Kafka topic. Then consumer will consume this message that we will see by using Kafka console. And in the next video, we will also create Kafka consumer demo with Spring Boot application. Now here we will create one model class that we will send as a message. So here I will create new class that is user and we'll create one more package that is model and finish. And here I will add the annotation that is data and also use all our constructor and at the rate no arg constructor. And here I will define properties private int user id and private string user name. And here I will use at the rate json properties. And here I will define the name for this property is like user ID. And add the username. Here I will define the JSON property name that is username. So here I have added two properties. And here I will use add the rate JSON include. And JSON include non null. Now I will create one more model class that will be the parent for all model classes. So here I have created message and at message class I will use at the rate data annotation and here I will declare one property that is common for all model instant and time create. So now what we need to do next, next thing we need to define the Kafka producer configuration. So here I will create one more package that is config package and we also need to create the controller, but first we will create Kafka producer config. So here I will create one class Kafka producer config and here in this class we will define at the rate bean annotation and we'll create the bean for producer config. So here I will define just method, that is public map of string, and here I will just pass the object, and the function name is producer config. And here I will just copy this map from here, and here I will create map, that is props is equal to new hash map, and here we need to add props dot put, and here we need to add key, so key will be producer config dot, first we will use bootstrap key, and here we need to define Kafka host, where is our Kafka is running. So first we need to start our Kafka. So here I will go to C drive, and inside C we have Kafka, and go to bin windows, and just here I will type cmd, and here we need to start first zookeeper, then we can start Kafka server. So here I will just paste the command here and click enter, then our zookeeper server will be start. After starting the zookeeper, now we need to run our Kafka server. So now I will go again to Windows cmd, and here we need to type the command that will run our Kafka server, Kafka server start dot bat, and click enter. Now our Kafka server has started. So now I will minimize this, and here I will define our private string Kafka host is equal to localhost 9092. So now I will copy this Kafka hosts and paste as a bootstrap server config. And next we need to add props.put. And here I will copy this producer config. And here we need to define key serializer. Key serializer class config. So here I will use string serializer class. String serializer from, so here I will just paste all the properties. So here I have just paste it, and now I will change it Kafka hosts as a name. Now what the next thing we need to create the bean for our producer factory. So here I will just paste it. So here after creating the bean for producer factory, also will create the bean for Kafka template, and this message class is our model class, so we need to import this message. So Kafka producer model message and save it. Now what we need to do, now we need to send the message from our controller. So here I will create one controller class. So first I will create one package, that is controller, and from this controller I will send the message and will be published to our topic. So here I will class, that is message controller, and here I will define the annotation, that is at the rest controller. And here I will create one endpoint that will be used to send the message, public user send user details. Here I will use at the rate request body, यूजर रिटर्न यूजर सर्विस, सो आई नीड टू क्रिएट वन मोर पैकेज. सो हियर आई विल क्रिएट वन मोर पैकेज दैट इज सर्विस लेयर, एंड इन साइड सर्विस लेयर आई विल क्रिएट वन मोर क्लास दैट इज सर्विस पैकेज, एंड हियर आई विल क्रिएट वन मोर क्लास मैसेज सर्विस. And here I will define annotation that is at the rate service. Now I will go to my controller back, that is message controller, and here I will auto void and inject the dependency. So here I will use auto void, and private message service that is service. Now here I will call service dot send user and will pass the object of user, and here it showing create method. So here I will create one method, and here I need to inject dependency of Kafka template so I can send the message to our Kafka topic. And Kafka template, so here we just need to create the bean for Kafka template, and here I will call Kafka template dot send, and here I will select the topic and message data. What is the topic name that we need to use? So here I am just creating one string, private string topic, that is my topic. So it will be final. Just copy this topic and paste it here, and user data will be sent to our topic. And now it's showing change user to message. So here we need to check our user class is not extends message class. So first we will extends message class here, that is Kafka producer model. So here we have extended this class, that is parent class for all the classes. Now I will go and see here, it's not returning any message. So I will return the user model from here. Now we have done each and everything. Now I will just run this application. So first we need to create one topic, that is Kafka topic. So here I will go and will create topic, that's name will be my topic. So here I will just paste this command to create the topic. And here we can see our topic is created topic, that's name is my topic. Now I will open console for my topic, and here I will paste the command, and this command will open the Kafka console consumer. So when the producer will produce the message, the all message will be we can see here, because it's consuming the same topic, that is my topic, and we will publish the message to my topic. So now we will run this application, run as Java application. And here we can see our application has started. Now I will open to Postman. Now here what we need to check, first we will go to our message controller, and here we need to add the rate post mapping. And here we can define URL for this, that is user. Okay, now I will stop and run again. Run as Java application. Now our application has started. Now I will go to Postman, and here I have defined the URL, and in body I have just passed the raw value. So here I have defined the user ID is 1 and username is Karan. So now I will click on send. Then here we can see it will return the response. But it's showing some internal, and here we can see it's showing java.lang class cast exception cannot be cast to model into string. So here I will go to our Kafka producer config, and here we just need to add the annotation that is at the rate configuration. So now I will stop it again and run this application again. Run as Java application. Application has started. Now I will go to my Postman and will hit the same URL again, and here we can see that is the response, user ID 1 and username is Karan. Now we will go to Kafka console consumer, and this is the Kafka console consumer. There we can see the message that we send from our API. So if I will change, so here I will send ID is 14 and name is Mohit, and click on send. And now I will go to our consumer, and here we can see the message. So I will just like this, and will send third message GGG, and this is our Kafka console, and click on send, and we can see here third message is also printed. So in this video we see how we created the Kafka producer and how this published the messaging to our topic, and in the next video we will see the Kafka consumer demo and how it will consume the message from our topic, that we will see in the next video. Okay, thanks for watching this video.